Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about an exciting change in Postgres 17 that will make significant improvement to vacuum performance for certain workloads. As always, when we talk about Postgres 17, it's important to call out that these things might still change. So Postgres 17 is expected to come out in September or October, and a lot of testing will happen between now and then. We're also about to be at feature freeze, so that means we're getting close to getting the final set of features in Postgres 17 that will likely be in there. Now today, I want to talk about this commit by Masahiko Sawada from earlier this week that improves how vacuum stores dead tuples. But let's go back a little bit on the background of this commit first. So this starts earlier here with the addition of an adaptive Radix tree implementation to Postgres. This is a commit by John Naylor earlier in March, but ultimately the benefit of a Radix tree is that it's more memory efficient and it's able to handle sorted keys more efficiently. Now, as noted in that commit, the initial proof of concept here was built by Anders Freund, and then after subsequent discussions, Masahiko Sawada and John Naylor took this proof of concept and productionized it. So now in Postgres, we have this general purpose Radix tree mechanism. And this is based on a paper, The Adaptive Radix Tree, ARTful Indexing for Main Memory Databases, by a couple of researchers in Germany from 2013. Now, if you're interested in all the details of that paper, feel free to take a look. But for today, we're going to focus on the Postgres benefits here. So in this commit, Masahiko added the TIDStore based on this Radix tree implementation. And if you're not familiar, TIDs, or tuple identifiers, are essentially how Postgres is able to say where is a particular row version or tuple located. Now, of course, what's a common place where you need this is an autovacuum. But when autovacuum or vacuum processes dead tuples that were caused by an update or deleting a table, autovacuum needs to remember where those tuples were in the table whilst it's vacuuming the indexes. The way this works is that the main table has a dead tuple, a dead row version, and then the index still points to that dead row. And so we need to go to index, remove the stale index entries to then be able to actually fully remove the dead tuple on the main table. And so this is one of the fundamental limits in autovacuum today on older Postgres versions, is that you actually have a 1 gigabyte limit here in terms of how autovacuum keeps track of this, which is essentially based on the fact that Postgres used to use, up until this commit, a simple array that stored these IDs. But now, thanks to the adaptive Radix tree implementation, this is much more memory efficient. So the idea here is that autovacuum workmem still controls the size of the Radix tree, but the benefit being that the Radix tree is much more memory efficient, and so we'll be able to keep many more dead tuple identifiers within the vacuum process, so we don't have to do multiple index phases. Multiple index phases, for context, that happens when autovacuum essentially runs out of working memory, and so it can't remember enough dead tuple information, and so it has to first go over all the indexes, and then after it's done, it needs to continue scanning the table. And so, of course, this means that we essentially have a lot of overhead for each of the indexes on our table because we have to vacuum it multiple times. Now, let's take a look at a practical example where this benefit can be seen. So locally, I have both Postgres 16 as well as Postgres 17 development branch as of earlier today running, as we're going to compare this behavior of autovacuum between the two versions. I can also show you here that the autovacuum workmem is set to the default, which is -1, which merely takes the value from maintenance workmem. Maintenance workmem is set to 64 megabytes on both of these. So that means this is the maximum amount of memory that autovacuum can use. I could raise this to 1 gigabyte, but it's actually more helpful to illustrate, so we'll keep it low. I'm going to create a table on both 16 and 17, that this table has 100 million records, and now we're going to create an index. This is an important step because the improvement here only matters on tables with indexes, which in production, most of the time, that's the case. Now let's first take a look at the size of this table. So this is a 3.4 gigabyte table that we're working with here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to update the whole table. And I'm essentially just going to reassign the IDs to be one less than they were before. And of course, this is a pretty significant change here, right? We're rewriting 100 million rows. So I'm going to use my time travel machine to accelerate this a little bit. All right, wonderful. And so now that the update has finished, Postgres will automatically kick up an autovacuum for us. And so if we check the pgstat progress vacuum view, we'll see here that vacuum is running right now. And as it's running, it now has to scan over the table. And you can already see that we just had our first index vacuum phase. So autovacuum already, after what probably was less than a minute, already ran into the autovacuum workmem limit here. So 64 megabytes worth of dead tuples, caused it to trigger an index vacuum phase. Now, after this index vacuum phase is done, we'll see that the index vacuum count went up by one. And we also see that now Postgres is vacuuming the rows that are marked as dead. And now it's scanning the heap again so they can find more dead row version. It does this again up to the 64 megabyte limit it can remember. And now we're vacuuming indexes again. Now, we'll skip ahead a little bit again until this is completed. It was a total of 9 index vacuum phases. And now we're just vacuuming the heap one last time. This is actually removing the dead rows. And there we go. All right, this took quite a long time. So let's take a look at the logs. So Postgres Autovacuum will produce a log output when you have it enabled. And this is quite dense and information rich, I would say. But the thing for now we care about is that we ran for a total of 770 seconds to vacuum this table. Let's go to Postgres 17 and repeat the same exercise. So we're going to also execute our update statement. And now that the update has finished, we can once again watch the vacuum that's running. Now you can see here one of the differences between 16 and 17 is that in 17 we're counting up dead tuple bytes, which is essentially how big that radix tree is that is the dead tuple information. And now as we scan more heap blocks, one thing that I think jumps out to me at least immediately is that we've already passed the number of heap blocks we scanned compared to what we did on Postgres 16, and we didn't kick off an index vacuum phase. So that's really the big benefit we can see here already is we're right now using about 13 megabytes of memory to remember a lot more dead tuples than we were able to remember on 16, 64 megabytes. And so really this is the benefit, is that we can now keep this metadata, we can keep scanning the heap, and then after it's scanned, we'll be able to do a vacuum index phase. Let's skip ahead to that. With only 37 megabytes of memory in use, we switch to vacuuming indexes phase. And so that means we only need a single index vacuum phase here now, which is a tremendous performance improvement. If you had multiple indexes to be scanned that were very large, this could take substantial amounts of time. And we now have a single index vacuum phase thanks to the adaptive radix tree. And now with the vacuum finished, let's look at our Postgres log output. We can see that here the total vacuum runtime was 619 seconds compared to the 773 seconds in Postgres 16. There's one last thing I want to show you, which is a visual comparison of how this behavior differs. So here, this is pganalyze showing vacuum statistics in Postgres 16. I'll pull up the test run that finished there. You can see this staccato-like behavior where Postgres keeps switching into the index vacuum phase and then switches back to vacuuming the heap. Versus on 17, what we can see is the test run that just finished has a single vacuuming index phase. Now, just visually, if you compare those two graphs, I think it shows very clearly that 17 is significantly better. It will also have less churn in your shared buffers. I'm really excited about this improvement in Postgres 17. A big thanks to Masahiko Sawada and John Naylor to get the adaptive radix tree implementation as well as the TIDStore committed to Postgres. I think this auto-vacuum performance improvement is an excellent change and look forward to future use cases for radix trees inside Postgres. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.